Hi there, Morgan here from Crafting a Lovely Life, and today I'm going to show you how to make this super cute Be Kind rainbow coffee mug using your Cricut mug press and infusible ink. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to layer different colors of infusible ink on a mug. If you are new to the Cricut mug press, then this is the perfect beginner project for you. Don't worry, if you don't have a mug press, you can also make this mug using permanent adhesive vinyl. I will link a video below showing you how to apply a permanent vinyl to mugs if you want to do that instead. All right, let's get started. The first thing we're going to do is open up a new project in Cricut Design Space and upload our design. The design I'm using today is available on my website, which I will link below. Once you have the image open, you can resize it to fit on the mug you are using. The height of my mug is almost 3.5 inches, so I'm going to make my design 3.25 inches tall so it will fit well. I also just want to note really quick that the type of mug you are using is very important when you are using infusible ink and the mug press. You cannot just use any mug you find at the store or in your house. The mug has to be a sublimation mug, otherwise the infusible ink will not infuse to the mug. I've linked the mug that I'm using today below, but you can also use Cricut brand sublimation mugs. Now that we have the design uploaded and resized, we need to get parts of the design attached so they will stay together while we cut them. So go ahead and select the entire image and click ungroup. Then select the blue layer and click attach. Now select the purple layer and click attach. The other two layers only have one design element in them, so we don't need to do anything with them. Since we want to have this design on both sides of our mug, we need to make a copy. So click and drag to select the entire image, and then right click on your mouse and select copy. Then move your mouse away from the design, right click and select paste. Now you should have two copies of the design, and they both should have the correct layers attached and ready to go. Click make it and we will get our mats arranged for cutting. I don't like cutting all of my colors on individual mats because it just takes extra time. So what I like to do is move everything over to one mat. To do this, you will go to the mat that you want to move, select the design element and click the three little dots on the image, and then click move object. Then you can select the mat you want to move it to. Once it's on the mat, you will need to move it down so that none of the cuts overlap. I also want to note that when you move everything over to one mat, it does change the color of that design element. So just make sure you're keeping track of what colors go where, otherwise you could get really confused when you actually go to place the infusible ink on the mat. Continue this process until all of the design elements are on one mat. Anytime you use infusible ink, you will also want to mirror the mats so that the design looks backwards when it is cut. If you decide to cut everything separately instead of on one mat, you will need to select the mirror option for each mat. So select mirror and click continue. Now we can select our material type. Search for infusible ink and then select more pressure. Anytime I cut infusible ink, I always select the more pressure option. This makes it so much easier to weed after it's cut. If you are using Design Space on a tablet or phone, you will not be able to select more pressure. That feature is currently only available when you are connected to a computer. Now we are ready to place the infusible ink on our standard grip cutting mat. Make sure you place the infusible ink with the ink side up and double check where you need to place the infusible ink in Design Space so that it covers all of the areas that will be cut. Also, you might notice that the colors look extremely muted. That is normal with infusible ink, and when the colors transfer to the mug, they will look vibrant, so don't worry. Once the ink is placed on the mat, I like to use a brayer tool to make sure the material is really stuck down well. Then load your mat and select the C button to start cutting. If you have never weeded infusible ink before, it is quite different from weeding other Cricut materials. The easiest way to weed infusible ink is to roll the ink sheet back and forth in your hands to loosen the cut parts of the material. Then you can peel away the bulk of the excess infusible ink. The first part of the design I am going to weed is the teal band on the rainbow and the heart. Then I will do the next band on the rainbow. Once I have the excess ink peeled off of this band, I'm also going to trim the plastic backing sheet down as close as I can to the infusible ink without accidentally cutting the infusible ink. You want to make sure that the infusible ink on each part of the design is completely uncovered so it can make direct contact with the mug, otherwise it will not infuse to the mug properly. Then we will repeat this process for the remaining rainbow band and the letters. When you are ready to weed the small pieces in between the letters, you will want to gently fold the design and use your hands to grab the smaller excess pieces of ink. Then cut the plastic backing sheet around the words down as far as you can and place it on the design. I like to flip over the design once I'm done placing everything just to make sure I like how it looks and don't need to make any adjustments. Then this process can be repeated with the second copy of the design. Next, to prepare our mug, we are going to use a clean lint roller to go over the mug to pick up any dirt or lint that might be on it. If you don't do this, you can have little spots appear on your mug after it's heated. Now we are going to place the design onto the mug. To get the design centered, you can cut a piece of tape and place it across the top of the mug. This will mark the center on each side. Then place the design on the mug, making sure all of the infusible ink is directly touching the mug's surface. I also like to take some heat-resistant tape and tape all around the edges of the design just to make sure everything stays in place. Then you can place the design on the other side of the mug using the same process. Now I have seen this done with and without butcher paper, but some do recommend placing a few layers of butcher paper on top of the infusible ink on the mug before it goes into your mug press. The worry is that the infusible ink could bleed through onto the mug press, which could ruin it. I typically will add layers of butcher paper around my design, but didn't do that for this mug and it worked out fine. So I would just do what you feel most comfortable with here. Before we turn on the mug press, I want to make sure to note that the mug press should be used in a well-ventilated area because it can cause irritation to sensitive individuals. I personally am very sensitive to this, so I use a mask. I also open a window and I have a fan going to make sure there's a lot of ventilation. Do what you feel comfortable with here, but Cricut does specifically state that this should be used in a well-ventilated area, so please use this product safely. Go ahead and turn on your Cricut mug press. The light will be orange while the mug press gets up to temperature. The handle on the mug press should be up while it is heating up. You should hear a beep and the light should turn green when it is ready. Place the mug into the mug press. Once the mug is in place, push down on the handle to start heating the mug. The lights on the top of your machine should blink to give you an idea of how far along the process is. The machine will beep again once the mug is done heating and you can lift up the handle and carefully remove it. Be sure to only touch the handle part of the mug because the rest of it will be extremely hot. Place the mug on a heat-resistant surface like the EasyPress mat and let it cool completely for about 30 minutes. Do not rush this part. I know it's hard to wait, but if you pull the design off too early, it could cause ghosting on the mug. Once the mug has completely cooled, you can remove the heat-resistant tape and butcher paper. Then peel up the plastic backing sheet to reveal your new mug. How cute is this mug? I absolutely love it. I also think it's a really great beginner project to get you started with using multiple colors when you're making mugs with infusible ink and your Cricut mug press. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and get a chance to make a cute mug of your own. Don't forget to grab this design on my website listed below. Be sure to subscribe below so you can follow along each week as I share new crafty projects. Thanks so much for watching. Bye!